Although the ASP.NET Core Web API framework provides all the built-in model binders to bind your incoming data with the .NET types, still we might have some scenarios where we need to manipulate the incoming data before actually binding it to a .NET type. In that scenario, we can create our custom model binder and we can use it directly, very simply, in ASP.NET Core Web API application. Let's understand how can we create a custom model binder and how can we use it in ASP.NET Core Web API application. Before creating the model binder, let's understand a scenario. Let's assume we are in a situation where we need to send some data in the query string or in the header, in the route or at some other place, but the main concept is in the data. For example, we are sending some values by using the pipe separation. But here on the ASP.NET Core side, we are using an array of that type. So in this scenario, the built-in model binder will not work. We have to create a custom model binder and we need to manipulate that data. What we will do? We will get the incoming data, then we will remove that pipe and we will convert it into an array. Once the data gets converted, then we will bind it to the parameters that we are using in our action method. Let's create a new action method over here. Inside the parameter, let's use an array of string type. Here I can write countries. To create the custom model binder, we need to create a new class in this application. Let's say I'm creating the new class at the root level. You can organize the structure as per your need, like you can create this class inside any folder, or you can give any meaningful name to your folder like custom model binders, something like that. Since we are learning about the concept, so here I am creating the class at the root level. So we have to choose add and hit this class. Let's give it a name, custom binder. Hit the add button. Now as a first task, we need to inherit this class from iModelBinder interface. Let's do that. This interface is available in this microsoft.asp.netcore.mvc.modelbinding. Now it is time to implement this interface in this custom binder class. So here you can notice that we have only one method and we need to work on this method. The main concept in this method is that we have model binding context, and this parameter will help us to read the incoming data, manipulate it and bind it as a result. Let's see how can we work on this custom model binder. So I am going to remove this line from here. In order to manipulate the data, first we need to get the data from this binding context. And remember, we can send the data either in the query string, route, header or at some other place. Let's understand some of the main concepts. So here let's say we are getting some data, and to get the data we need to focus on this binding context. From this binding context we need to go to this HTTP context and then use the request. Here in this request object, you will get everything about the HTTP incoming request details. Now enter the dot, and here you can notice that there are some properties. First is query, headers, body, schema, path, etc. By using these properties, we can get the actual value. Let's say we are assuming that the incoming data is available in the query string. So we can use the query. Now from this query, we need to convert that data to some specific type. Let's see how can we do that. We have to use the try get value. By using this try get value, we can read the incoming data. Let's understand the details of this method. Right click on this one and choose go to definition. So here you can notice that we have to pass two parameters. First is the key and second is a value. And remember, the second parameter is of type out. So we will get the data from this key and the actual value will be available in the second parameter. So let's do that. Let's assume the name of the query string is countries, and here we need to pass the second parameter. Because it is of type out, so we have to use this out keyword. Here we are passing two parameters. First is the countries. This is the name of the query string that we will use in our URL. And here as a second parameter, we are passing another variable. We are using this variable for the out, and the actual value of this countries will be available in this country field. Let's do some further manipulation on this country data. we can check if the result is true. This method is going to return a boolean value. If the conversion is successful, then we will get a true value over here. So here let's assume if everything is true, then we will convert this data to an array. First we can convert this country to the string, then apply the split method, and in the split we can pass the pipe because we are going to split the data from the pipe. At this place the manipulation of the data is done. Now whatever data we are getting in the request, from that data we are removing the pipe and we have an array of string. Now we have to bind this manipulated data to the actual parameter that we are using in the action method. So for that we have to use the binding context.result. And let's set its value. Once the binding of the data is done, then we need to complete this task, and we can do that easily by using the task completed. That's it. Now the custom model binder is ready. We have to just simply use it in our action method. Let's see how can we do that. Let's navigate to the countries controller, and here let's say I want to use this custom model binder. To use that custom model binder in this parameter, we have to use some attributes, and for that we have to use the model binder. Then we need to provide what type of model binder you are using in this parameter. The type is the name of our new custom model binder, and the name is custom binder. The name of this class we have to use in the type. And just for the testing, let's return this entire data in this OK method. Now everything is done and we just need to test the custom model binder. Let's run this application by pressing this green button. The application is running. Now let's open the Postman. Here we can make the changes in our existing request. So this time we have to use this URL, and here in the query string we need to pass some data. So here let's pass some name of the countries. Let's say I'm passing four names. The type of the API is get, so we have to use the get method over here, and before actually sending the request let's put a breakpoint. So here we can put the breakpoint, and now let's send the request. Here we got the debugger, and let's see what we got in these countries. Here you can notice that we have all four countries and these are available as an array over here. Let's hit the continue button. And here is the output. The concept of custom model binder is that we are sending some data in this form. Here we are separating all the countries by using the pipe symbol, and in the action method we are treating this data as an array of the string. Now let's debug the model binder also. Let's send the request again. Let's see what we got in this binding context. So here you can notice that we have all the details: action context, binder model name. We will also learn the concept of this binder model name in upcoming video. So here is the binding source. This is the name of the field that we are using in the action method, and all other details. Now let's see what we got in this HTTP context. So here you can notice that we have the connection details, feature, form options, HTTP context, items, request. Let's go inside this request. And here we have all the details of this incoming HTTP request. This is the path. We are using this URL to access the action method, and it is available over here. The type of the method is get. Is HTTPS? Yes, this is true. Here is the name of the host. All the headers that we are getting in this request are available at this place. Here are all the keys. This is how we can access everything from this request. Now we have to focus on our incoming data. So let's press the F10 button. And let's see what we got in our country. In this country field you can notice that we have all the values that we are sending from our request. The fetching of the data is successful, that is why we are having true value over here. So if everything is true, we need to convert it to the string and then split it from the pipe. Let's see what we got over here. Here we got an array of type string, and here we have all four values. I am using this example just to focus on the concept. In your case, you might have some different scenario and you need to manipulate your data by using some other techniques. But the main concept is that read the data from the incoming request, manipulate it, and then bind it as a result in this binding context by using this model binding result dot success method. So hit the continue button. In this learning, you can also focus on one important concept, that if you are using the custom model binder, then before actually hitting this action method, the request is passing through the model binder that we are using in this particular parameter. So this is how the custom model binder works in ASP.NET Core Web API.